this isn't the company, get off this line. It was very rude to me, and it raised the flags. I said, what is this guy? It got my curiosity up. So after a day or two, I went back in on the line again with the story that I was White Plains for a tandem test switching system with the AT&T network, and we had a problem on the line. And we asked him, I says, what company have we reached? And he said, we've reached the White House CIA crisis hotline number. We says, well, we'll fix the problem as soon as we can. Thank you very much. That was all I needed. Once I got the number, I found the 7-digit equivalent of that number, which I needed to use for auto verify. And I was able to sit on that line for a while and listen to calls coming in. Most of the calls coming in were encrypted or scrambled. So I said, wow, this is an interesting line. I was able to catch a call just as it got started. Before they turned on the encryption. What they do is they make direct contact first, then they encrypt the call. During one of the direct contacts, I was able to hear what appeared to be a very important call going in there. And they said, Olympus, please, in plain text, in plain English. It was a code name for President Nixon. What came next was the encryption. So I couldn't hear anything that they were saying. Then later on, we decided to call that number. I was at a party in LA, and I was upstairs, and some phone freaks were downstairs, and I wanted some information from them, and I had to have something to trade. So I traded that number for another number that I wanted. So they took that number, and I told them, it's a CIA crisis hotline number. Olympus will get you President Nixon. And they says, no, that's not true. I says, well, go ahead and call the number, but have your story straight. And be sure to call the number from an untraceable line. And so we were able to get jump through a couple of hops to the number, and we got the person on the other end. With an authoritative voice, we said, Olympus, please. And a voice came on that sounded like President Nixon. And my friend grabbed the phone away from me and said, sir, we have a crisis in Los Angeles. Sir, we're out of toilet paper.
I love it. You didn't just prank call the president. You did it on the CIA crisis line.
The CIA crisis line was a special line they used to set up for calling on rather important issues.
Yes, Russians are moving ICBMs. They're loading them onto rail cars, sir. They're moving them towards the Polish border.
But the capability of what I could do really scared a lot of people. I could get into the Audubon network. That was the military telephone network.
And for those that don't know, this is a great service to show how there's back doors in all these computers and the phone systems and in all the tech. Because you talk about, you're a conspiracy theorist. This is a fact built into it so they can spy. And you are the guy that began to expose it day one.
Yeah, Pentagon didn't believe it. But I was able to show them that a switch in Murphy Dome was able to forward and pass a call to another military switch.
And of course, the telecoms, the corporations that built it, they all knew that. So that's why this is a corporate takeover. So getting back to Nixon and other things, they didn't come arrest you, right? I mean, they tried a few times. Instead, they figured out, hey, we should try to recruit this guy to really show us what's going on. And that kind of started the whole move towards recruiting hackers into the government, right?
Well, kind of right. But the big thing that got everybody interested in the whole thing in the first place was the Esquire article. Steve Wozniak found a copy of the Esquire article on his coffee table at his home.
I'll tell you what, stay there. I'm going to give you the floor when we come back to talk about all the history you've been involved in. And then I've got to get into current stuff that's happening. Captain Crunch's view on the NSA, the Panopticon system, Big Brother, Edward Snowden. and so much more coming up. But, folks, you heard him. He needs your help. So if you appreciate all that Captain Crunch has done for liberty and freedom on the web, you need to give him some support, folks. And that's webcrunchers.com, webcrunchers.
My Magic Mud is a tooth whitening powder that removes plaque and detoxifies your mouth. It's safe for your enamel, giving you a beautiful polish and a dentist-like clean after every use. My Magic Mud is also the perfect remedy for pain caused by sensitivity. It strengthens your teeth and gums for a strong, healthy smile. The ingredients are 100% natural, and it's safe for children. Simply brush with My Magic Mud right before bedtime for a cleaning you can count on. Visit MyMagicMud.com.
Digestive health is key to wellness, and Pro-EM-1 is the key to digestive health. Pro-EM-1 is a daily liquid probiotic that improves food absorption and supports weight loss by removing toxins from your system. Recommended by doctors, Pro-EM-1 is 100% natural, organic, non-GMO, wheat, soy, gluten, and dairy-free. Call us today at 888-611-8025 or visit Pro-EM-1.com to save over $25 on your order. That's 888-611-8025 or Pro-EM-1.com.
What good is a Big Berkey water filter?
We get that question a lot here at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. And in a word, the answer is protection. Protection from water main breaks, E. coli contamination, environmental chemical spills, pesticide runoff, chlorine taste and smell, and all forms of fluoride. Plus, Big Berkey water filters are the original gravity water filter system and most trusted on the market for a reason. Tested by multiple independent NSF EPA certified labs, they are the gold standard in water purification. At only 1.7 cents a gallon, a single set of filters can last for 5 to 10 years. That means big savings. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get a Big Berkey today at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. GCN listeners receive 5% off all ceramic filter systems. Visit our website or call 1-877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
Are you happy doing your laundry with perfume detergents that irritate your skin? Are you happy washing your hands with stinking fragrances that gives your skin rashes? Are you happy paying new, higher prices for smaller boxes? Find your happiness today with our 1 to 4 year supply of Pure Soaps or our 1 to 2 month sampler with bar soap, shampoo, laundry, and dish soap at 5starsoap.com. You deserve the best. Happiness is 5starsoap.com.
In today's unstable environment, self-protection is critical. Civil unrest, riots, looting, it's happening now, right here in the United States, and your rights are at risk. If passed, H.R. 5344 would ban level 3 and above body armor. Katie Armor is standing up for you. We offer the most affordable level 3 body armor on the market. Katie level 3 armor withstands pistol and rifle hits up to 7.62 NATO. Get yours at katiearmor.com. That's C-A-T-I-armor.com. Katie Armor, come and take it.
Warnings of an American collapse hit us nearly every day. Gear up while you still can with Infidel Body Armor. Don't spend between $500 and $600. Infidel is available for just $374.99 with free shipping within the U.S. Made in America and legal in all 50 states. Resist tyranny with Infidel Body Armor. Buy yours today at InfidelBodyArmor.com. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
I hear the train coming. It's rolling around.
You're listening to the Alex Jones Show. I'm Alex Jones, your host. The news websites are PrisonPlanet.com and InfoWars.com. WebCrunchers.com is John Draper's website. And we'll tell you coming up a little bit later how you can go there and support him. He is the undisputed Grand Poobah, Big Kahuna, granddaddy, father of hacking, undisputed. And it's one of those niche things, but a very important niche thing that the general public probably doesn't know who Captain Crunch is, but to the hackers and that whole community out there, there's a lot of going on right now because he's such an interesting guy and such a trailblazer on so many fronts. Now, I want to get into what's happening in modern times right now with you, sir, but you'd gotten up to the Army, the Pentagon, not believing that you were able to do this. And then, of course, big investigations came out of that because the Pentagon didn't know the telecoms had put in a system where they could spy on everybody, including foreign telecoms. So, John Draper, Captain Crunch, please continue.
Okay, well, as I was stationed, I was stationed up at Indian Mountain Air Force Station, Alaska, and I had to do a one-year stint up there. And during my time up there, I had lots and lots of time. It didn't take me long to figure out how to get into the Audubon system to make free phone calls home. And they encouraged you to do that because for morale purposes and things like that, they actually had a special day set up where people could make calls over the Audubon just for personal use. And so as I was experimenting around, being back home and on the private commercial network, there's a switch up there that was passing Audubon calls because it was being used for both commercial and also military use. And they didn't believe it. And then Adam Bauman in the book, Adam was featured as, I believe, he was the one who actually snitched on me. His actual name, I'm going to get it for you in a minute here, because I want people to know who he is. His name is, it's Sheridan. So if you read the book, Exploding the Phone, and they refer to a person, Sheridan, he is the FBI informant that got really good friendly with me and was able to inform the FBI of these things. And he tried to do it, and the FBI tried to do the Audubon. They were unable to do it. Only I was able to, because it took a lot of finesse to be able to do it, because you had to be very careful with the level of the tones. The tones had to be really, really accurate. But I was able to slip the tones through this switch, which gave me direct access to the military Audubon network. And from there, I could do anything. I could do priority interrupt calls. I could do a flash override in the NORAD and cause a few heads to roll. These things existed, and I did my very best to try to explain to the FBI that these things existed, but they just didn't believe me. The opportunity that I had to talk to the FBI was during my plea arrangement. I was basically forced to tell the FBI what I did and everything that I did. And so they rented a room inside San Francisco Hotel, and I appeared. They had about four or five agents in there, including some security experts. And they contacted the Pentagon, and the Pentagon actually could not figure out how that could be done. Rachel, in the book Exploding the Phone, whose real name is Adam Bauman, was the person who tried and was unable to do it, despite the fact they had all the equipment. So going on to encryption and protection and privacy and things like that, I certainly believe people should use encryption for any kind of communication that they use. There's a program called PGP or GPP, your GPG. You can download it on the net. You can install it in your browser. And if you install it in your browser will have a little button there that says encrypt your message. So just with one button and with Google Chrome and Gmail, you can encrypt your mail relatively easily. It's a little bit difficult to install, but it works quite well once it gets going.
Well, Captain Crunch, we've got a long 18-minute segment coming up, and I want to cover the waterfront with you because my mind is racing with all the questions I could ask you. Obviously, they've made films about you. They're making more, I'm told. But it's just there's so much to talk about. I want to get into some more of your background, but then I want to accelerate into FBI reportedly raids home of second Snowden. contractor could face federal charges. I want to get your view on the fact that the NSA told us they weren't spying on us, when, of course, they've been spying pretty much all along. But now they're spying on people for their political views. Stay with us.
We're on the